Bloomberg talked exclusively earlier on today to St. Louis Fed President James Bullard. He talked about the impact of trade tensions on the global economy and why he thinks the Fed should consider more insurance cuts.
What we're seeing is day-to-day, tit-for-tat, which is a normal part of any negotiating situation. We have more trade uncertainty, and businesses are going to have to take that uncertainty on board. I want to lower now because I think we want to take out insurance against these risks and the idea that the trade war might morph into something more serious.
Voting member Jim Bullard. Joining us now for more insight on the Fed and where policy goes from here, Frederic Mishkin, Columbia University Graduate School of Business professor and, of course, former Federal Reserve governor. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Nice to see you here in London. Jim Bullard thinks that the trade situation merits some insurance cuts. The market's got a couple of cuts priced in between now and Christmas. You agree with that?
No, I don't. I think that the issue of the trade uncertainty is a very big deal. And I think that, that one of the things that we've learned when we worry about the zero lower bound, the fact that interest rates can't be driven below a certain point, is that you have to act very aggressively when you have actually negative shocks to the economy. The problem here is that nothing's really happened yet. Particularly in the U.S. economy, this is not always true elsewhere. The economy is very strong. We're in a situation where inflation is a little bit low, but not very far below where we want it to be. And we're running a very high-pressure economy. We're at unemployment rates that haven't been around for 50 years. So in that context, my view is that you actually want to react very quickly if you think there is actually going to be a problem, not just because there's a risk that there's a problem. And in particular, the reason why I say that in this particular environment is that anything can happen on trade. We have a very mercurial president on many, many different issues, and that I think he has strong incentives to make a deal, probably not a very good one. It could also go very, very south and be a disaster, but we just don't know. Anything could happen. And so my view is when we're in a situation where we're where we are right now with the economy actually quite strong and unemployment so low, then in fact you really want to wait till you actually have information, but to actually be preemptive if the information comes in. If things go badly on the trade front, then the Fed has to act very quickly.
Have the rate cuts thus far then been a mistake?
I actually would have preferred that the Fed wait. I think that there's been a real problem of communication at the Federal Reserve. And here is the issue. Central bankers hate to say how they'd react in the future because they think it boxes them in. It's actually very important for them to say, not that I'm going to do X in the future, but here are different scenarios for what could happen. And in fact, if that does happen, then I'm going to act and act very quickly. That way, it could deal with the problem that there is a lot of risk from the trade front, but you now can deal with it in a way that the markets will actually help you out. As soon as information starts to come in that actually tells you that there's a real problem, the markets actually will start to cut rates for you. And in fact, this is a basic principle of good communication, that it's really not good enough to just say that we're data dependent. You have to be much more specific about how you're going to do that. And then I think it would solve some of the problems that Jim Bullard is worried about, which is that the trade issues could spiral out of control and be a big problem for the U.S. economy.
But Rick, are you suggesting then that there would be some kind of an emergency cut if we were to suddenly see some kind of an effect on the economy from the trade stagnation?
Yeah, I think that in fact the way the Fed could operate is to basically get out in front even before that, to say that in fact if there's a big problem, we will act quickly so that we're not going to get behind the curve. But on the other hand, right now the economy is doing very well. In fact, saying that we're worried about the economy may not help actually the economy. But if in fact something really bad does happen, then the Fed's got to react and react very quickly and very aggressively. I think that's a better way to operate policy right now, but there are different views on this. It's not obviously not a clear-cut situation at all.